Since this sameness is present, true, and good, there is a way in which men should view women, and there is a way in which women should view men, that if we line ourselves up with how God designed the universe to work, we'll flourish. And where we refuse to do that, there's going to be major issues. Number one, this is because the Imago Dei is true. This is how men must view women. Men must think biblically of women and not push against the stereotypes of women as mere sexual creatures or servants put here for our pleasure and comfort. Number two, because of the Imago Dei, men must think biblically of women and treasure them as sisters and co-heirs, daughters of the King, and glorious, not dismissing them intellectually or robbing them of the right to exercise their gifts within God's beautiful design. And women, whether single or married, must think rightly about being representatives of God, made in His image and fulfilling His purposes. In the same way, women must think biblically about men and push against the stereotypes of men as idiot Neanderthals. Okay, do you watch television? Do you watch sitcoms? Is it not true that in every sitcom, the main male character is a high-functioning moron? In fact, the most long-running series on television is The Simpsons. What do we know about Homer? Safe to say, not a genius? Yeah. Yeah. You must fight against this, women, which leads me to number two. Women must think biblically and have high expectations for how men approach them and honor them as sisters. Because of the Imago Dei, because of ladies, because of your intrinsic value to God on high, you must not treat yourself cheaply. You must have high expectations for how men approach you, high expectations for how they honor you. You must understand your value before God in such a way that you will quickly and easily reject little boys who can shave, who seek sexual company, but will not honor your soul.